got inspiration for this recipe off of latinofoodie.com and then also from Kristen's vegetable share, fall vegetable share that she gets from Lancaster Farm Fresh. There's some vegetables and also some radishes. So I'm gonna pickle the onions and the radishes at the same time. I don't know how traditional pickling radishes is, but I'm still going to do it. So what we need is a pound of red onions. I don't have red onions, all I have is white onions, but these are the ones that we use. Or maybe these are yellow. These must be yellow onions actually. And then, so this is, I'm trying to weigh this out. We'll put these aside for now. All right, first, I'm gonna put the link in the box below on where to get this recipe. I'm gonna kind of modify it a little bit as we go though. So the first step is using a mandolin or a sharp knife, cut the onions into 1/8-inch thick half moons. All right. Buy one, but I've never used it because I'm scared to use it. Slice it up. I hope this is getting thin enough. Now we'll chop the radishes. Slice them, I mean. I'm not very big into making your vegetables look perfect before you prepare them, so I'm just going to take these tops off. These radish greens would be perfect to use in a green smoothie. It'd be a little peppery, a little spicy. I think they'd be great. Slice the radishes pretty thin. Once again, it doesn't have to be perfect. Sure the water's on its way to boiling. Last piece is a little thick. All right. So now my vegetables are chopped. Sliced. They're sliced. In a heavy medium pot, combine the onions, water, garlic, salt, and bay leaf. This thing turned off. induction hot plate. It's never seen one before, but the top of it doesn't get hot, but it heats up the pot. I don't know how that works, but it sounds awesome. So I'm gonna combine the onions. I've already got 5 cups of water in here. I'm just gonna put my onions in the pot. And my radishes. One dried bay leaf. White vinegar. I got this Regina white wine vinegar at Weiss Markets down the road from my house. You know what? Just take this little plastic thing off of here. That's the vinegar. Onion, water, garlic, salt, and bay leaf. I need 2 large cloves of garlic. My hands are cold or something. Shelling garlic is a little bit of a pain. I always chop the end off. Just sort of pick it off with my fingers. Again, I don't know where I learned to do it like that. I'm sure there's a better way to do it, but this is how I do it. And when it says to smash the garlic clove, you literally take the side of the knife, smash it. Salt. And I'm going to put a tablespoon of salt in. All the way. Hopefully it'll boil soon. I'll keep it boiling for 2 minutes. The nice thing about pickled onions is that you can put them on pretty much any Mexican themed dish. I use them on the carnitas that I just made, and I'm also going to put them on the stuffed peppers, which I'm about to make. Alright, so now our vegetables, radishes, and onions have been boiling. And I just realized that I put the vinegar in here, and I didn't need to do that yet, so I don't think it matters. Drain these out. Just use extra vinegar. Basically just draining the water off of them. Boiling them like that makes them like softer. It'll be a better finished product than if you don't boil them. Alright, so return this to the pot. Alright, they're going to be extra vinegary. I Regina white wine vinegar. I'm definitely gonna have to get more of this. This is really good for cooking. All right. Now I put the remaining ingredients. So, remaining ingredients are 1/4 teaspoon of the ground cumin. Teaspoon of Mexican oregano, and 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper, which I think is over here. Really hate opening this stuff. I skin my knuckles every time I have to open this thing. Oh well. That's what you go through when you want to get a delicious finished product. Now I'm going to turn this back on and bring it to a boil. Stir this around a little bit. Okay, it says once at a boil, remove from heat and cover. And let it cool for 1 hour. Once it's cool, I'll just take the contents of the pot, all of them, and put them into, where's that jar? Oh, here. This nice jar, very decorative. Here is the finished product. These are the pickled onions I made yesterday. Let's get a closer look up of these. And we had them on our carnitas, and we're going to be having them soon on the beef and what do you call it? Peppers, stuffed peppers. So I'm excited about that. All right. So if you are interested in making this recipe, I'm going to put the recipe, the link to it in the box below. Please give me a thumbs up and a share. And thanks for joining me today. It's fun to cook with you.